to lock that in because that's going to be a runout edge. As long as we can get it through without it coming apart. All right, I need my pin buckets. Got some new ones mixed in the batch now, and they are really hard to get apart. Alrighty, second pass. Leaving on a jet plane. I want to be right on that edge there. You start getting big and you're losing material. I gotta hold these tight. And this is finished pass, so I want to try and make this nice and neat right up against the edge of the foot. Boy, he moved my dang light. All right, here we go. Because the Tanara thread doesn't burn very well, I take that first snip and the underlayers just to cut through the Tanara, because with the hot knife, the Tanara just doesn't want to burn. It has a really high melting point. So it's just easier to go through and prep these by trimming away my underling. Come on, get out of there. And cutting through the Tanara. That way when I come up to it, I can just blow right past it. I burn it the rest of the way down and continue on. But if you don't trim these away, that's where the pin goes right there. That's where the hole is. So that'll be the, when these all come together, there's like six layers thick and it's just too much to get a snap through. All right, now I do need a piece of scrap material for fill-ins as we go around the outside corners. Put that over there just to hang on to. Thank you. cut right there that I didn't make. I believe that's going to be an outside corner. Yeah. Yeah, so what we do there... so that we'll fold it back under when we make the second pass. Where it's all semi-flat felled together, you need to cut away the one on the under because it does get really thick. And then another piece of cheater to fill in that gap. Down to just a little tiny bit in the middle that still gets hot. But I try not to waste. But at a certain point, it takes it too long to heat up for me to sit around and wait for. Although I should have plenty of hours on this boat to complete the tasks that I need to complete.